So we made it to 30. We're 3/4 of the way through the practice test. Here we go. Again, this reminds me how much work this is, but I think this practice test, it helps you to focus on what's on the test, helps you to focus on what you need to know, and it's very valuable. So first of all, I look at this thing, I've got a function right here. So that's probably all I need to use, but let's read this. If the rate of inflation is 4.01, oh, there's a, yeah, per year, the future value P of T in dollars, so the future price, so this is a price of a certain item, can be modeled by the following exponential function where T is the number of years from today. So T is in years. This is going to be a price of an item. So remember, from exponentials, 4.1% is 0.041. It's going up, so you get the 100% of its price plus this. So 100% as a number is 1, so that's, yeah, just 1 plus that. So that's where the 1.041 comes from, just in case you were interested. And then each year we multiply by this, so that's what the exponent is. And they don't tell us, but where it starts, the current price, well, I guess we're asking that. The current price is 2,000. So remember, exponential functions are a times the base to the x, or t, or whatever you want to go with t. A is our starting value. This is B, that's not a 6, it looks like a 6. A is our starting value. B is our, well, it's not the rate, but B is 1 plus the rate. And so if they want to get at the rate is B minus 1. Right, subtract 1 from both sides, so we go that way. Again, we don't have to know that, but the current price is going to be 2,000. So you could just say, oh, I see it there, it's 2,000. So I'll enter that. The other way to get at that, if you didn't remember that 2,000 is going to be the starting price, is to say, okay, current price, that's year 0, so that's P of 0 equals 2,000. Times 1.041 raised to the 0 power, because it's year 0. It's starting, it's before, yeah, it's not even, it's the beginning of time for us, at least for this item. So anything to the 0 power is 1. If you're not sure, go ahead and plug it in your calculator, but you'll see that this is equal to 2,000. Okay, so even if you forget that number in front is going to be our starting value, the current value, you can do it by remembering that we're at time 0. Price 9 years from today, well, that's P of 9, because T is how many years. So that's 2,000, 1.041 raised to the 9 power. Okay, and for that we can use the graphing calculator. Well, we don't need a graphing calculator, and they don't give it to us, so that's good. We just can use our regular calculator, 2,000. Times, or you could just put the parentheses, 1.041 parentheses raised to the 9 power. And we just hit enter. And $2,871 and round to the nearest dollar. The 3 is down, so it's just 2,871, nearest dollar. Okay, so the price has gone up quite a bit in 9 years, $2,871. And that would be like a 4% inflation rate. That's, I think, where we're currently at right now. It goes up and down. I think that I looked up the average, it's like 3% or something over the last 100 years. Anyway, take a look. This is the effect of inflation. Thank you very much.